Hola, fellow travelers. Mark here with Wolters World, and we're in Lisbon, Portugal, my old stomping grounds. I lived here for 5 years. I love Portugal, but even a place I love like Portugal, I know there's things that'll shock a tourist when they come here. So what we have for you today are the 10 things that are gonna shock you when you come to visit Portugal. Now, the first thing that's gonna shock you is when you go out to eat, and you're gonna have to pay for the bread and butter. Yes, the bread on the table, the butter on the table, the olives. These things you do pay for here, and they actually are in the menu now, you'll see that. But the thing is, if you're coming from the US or other places that, oh, chips and salsa is free, bread is free, here it's not the case. And I know people that have actually spent more money on the bread, the cheese, and the ham that they've been given. They spent more money on that than they did on their actual meal, okay? So be careful with that one. So you might be shocked. Yes, you do have to pay for the bread and butter in most places. Not everywhere, but just pay attention. Now, if you don't eat it, you don't have to pay. You don't want it, you say no thank you, they'll take it away, no problem. All right, so, but that'll be the first thing that shocks you. The second thing that may shock you is also due with the restaurants, is the fact that a lot of the places will close the kitchens between 3 and 7 or 8 o'clock at night. So if you're a tourist and you're used to eating at 5 o'clock in the afternoon for dinner, realize you're gonna have to go to more tourist areas to get dinner, okay? So there's places here in Lisbon that do open throughout the day and the kitchen is all the time, but a traditional tashka, like a family-run restaurant, they'll serve food from about 11 to about 3, and then they'll serve food again from 7 till 11 or 12. Now the thing is, the restaurants won't necessarily close during the day or during that off time. What they'll do is they'll have what are called salgados, like little savory treats, maybe croquettes of meat, or you can get a tosta mista, a toasted ham and cheese sandwich. But if you want, you know, bacalhau bras or bacalhau con natas or porco preto, the really awesome dishes here, it's hard to get in the late afternoon hours. So that's gonna shock you. But just know, if you want the real tashka Portuguese experience, you might have to wait for it, okay? The third thing that might shock you when you come here, and this is actually the first thing that shocked me the first time I came to Portugal, Portuguese bullfighting. Now, if you go to Spain, you see the olé, olé stuff, and you see the swords and things like that. Portuguese bullfighting, they don't kill the bull in the stadium. And the thing is, it's more horse riding in the beginning. They ride the horses around to tire out the bull. And then there's a bunch of guys in these kind of funny outfits and green hats. They kind of look like Portuguese elves. They go out there and they literally, and they catch the bull. I'm not kidding. The bull charges him. They catch the bull. It is completely insane. When you see it the first time, it will shock you. If you're here in the summer or the fall, you might see it on TV and you're just like, what the heck? Yes, Portuguese bullfighting, where they actually catch the bull, it'll shock you. The fourth thing that might shock you when you come to Portugal, especially if you come from the US, is the Portuguese love to smoke. They smoke a lot here. And you'll see people outside and in the cafes and outside banks and outside offices smoking, smoking, smoking. There's no stigma on smoking here in Portugal. So a lot of people when they come from the US, like, oh my God, everyone here is smoking. Not everyone, but yes, smoking is quite common here. And that does shock some tourists that yes, you can't smoke next to people. And the thing is, they do have a law, you can't smoke inside unless you have designated smoking areas. So if you're flying in and out of Lisbon, they actually have like a small, like cordoned off area that's just for smokers, okay? The fifth thing that might shock you when you come here as a tourist is trying to find good lower price and middle price hotels. There's definitely a lack of those in Portugal. So if you're looking for hotels, you're not gonna get much great stuff, lower end, middle end prices. So what I recommend is, Portugal actually has some of the best hostels. I know, hostels. Mark, I'm 40 years old, 30 years old, I don't go to hostels. They have family rooms there, they have stuff like that. But honestly, Hostel World has ranked a lot of the Portuguese hostels, especially here in Lisbon, some of the best in the world. And also, Portugal is really good with vacation rentals, getting an apartment. We're staying here in an apartment this time, and it's great. We got bedrooms, we got laundry, we got all kinds of stuff, so you're gonna go that way. But trying to find a cheap hotel or a middle price hotel that's good is kind of tough. So stick to hostels, a rented apartment, or go high price, okay? But it is kind of shocking where, you know, you can go from Germany or Austria and you find like good middle price stuff and you don't have so much of that here. Now, the sixth thing that might shock you about Portugal is their concept of time. Going out to lunch, yes, that's gonna be 2 hours. Going out to dinner, yes, it could be a 5 hour affair. We went to go have lunch with our friends in Sintra the other day. We ended up at their house for 11 hours. time in Portugal is quite relative, okay? So when someone tells you, hey, let's have dinner at 7, what they probably mean is 8 or later, okay? So don't be surprised. So if you meet Portuguese people and they're really nice and they speak English really well and they invite you to do something and they say, oh, let's meet at 8, you just say, hi, I'm from a country where 8 o'clock means 7:55. When should I be there? Okay, so just do those things. It'll make your life a lot easier. But the concept of time here does get some of the tourists upset because they're always getting a coffee or having a cigarette or things like that. Now, the seventh thing that may shock you about Portugal and may give you white knuckles is the driving. Oh my goodness, it's like every Portuguese person has a little rally driver inside them and it's going zoom, 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 zoom. It doesn't matter where you are in the country, it's like little rally drivers everywhere. And if you take taxis, which you will because they're nice and affordable here, you will feel that, oh my God, I'm going to die feeling. And the thing is, yes, they do drive kind of crazy here and they drive very fast. But one of the weird things is I found that if I'm in the crosswalk, they actually do stop for me. But if I'm walking on the sidewalk and I get a little too close to the edge, woo, hey, it gets a little close there. So be careful. One, if you're driving or if you've got little kids, you keep them next to you all the time, okay? Because the driving here is nuts, like white knuckle driving, scared out for your life in the taxi sometimes. Yes, that can happen. So just know that, all right? Now, the eighth thing that might shock you is when you come here to Lisbon, you're gonna get somebody that offers to sell you sunglasses. And then you'll say, no, no, I don't need sunglasses. And then they'll say, oh, hashish, cocaína? You want like marijuana or cocaine instead? You're like, whoa, whoa, whoa. That escalated quickly. Look, these people, they're trying to sell you drugs. They're not selling you real drugs anyway. And Portugal has decriminalized most drugs. So the cops don't really do anything about it. It's just one of those little annoyances. But just know, if you're a tourist, and that's the key. Locals say, I don't see this very often. It's the tourists that get asked. Stand outside the Rosio station where you go to Sintra. There's a Starbucks there. There's people selling drugs all the time. We're there with some friends of ours. Their son is 15. Guy came up, would you like some drugs? Like, no, thank you. I'm gonna go take a train to Sintra instead. Oh, okay, these kind of things. So they do ask you hashish, marijuana, cocaine. Just say no, thanks, because they're not selling you real drugs anyway. It's all fake anyway. All right, but it does kind of shock people. And they've asked my mom, who's a little bit older than me, if she wanted drugs. She's like, no, thank you. So that might shock you when you're here in Lisbon. That's more of a Lisbon-centric thing. Now, the ninth thing that might shock you when you come here is how affordable Portugal is. This is a cheap vacation. To stay, to eat, to travel, it is extremely affordable, okay? So when you come here, your money goes a lot farther. You know, you get one of the small beers here, it's a euro. Okay, that same small beer in Sweden is like $8, all right? So you do have a much better time here. Your money goes a lot farther. And you see a lot of tourists have started to see that. So you get tons and tons of tourists coming to Portugal now for these great prices. So I tell people, they're looking for a warm, easy place to go. I say, look, Portugal's great. A lot of the people speak English. They're very friendly. They got great food and it's affordable. So it's a great combination. And there's direct flights all over Europe and to the US from here. So Philly, Newark, places like that. It really makes it a great place to go. So you'll be shocked how affordable it is. You're like, wow, I can get all this stuff. Did they miss something up? No, they didn't. They got it right, okay? So that kind of shocks people how affordable it is here. And then the 10th thing that might shock you when you're here is you'll see the cobblestones here in Portugal, these little tiny squares put together, and they have designs and stuff like that, and it's beautiful. But the thing is, they can be slick as snot. So if you're here and you see the water coming on me, this is from the fountain. This stuff can get very slick. And if you're wearing high heels and stuff like that, it can be very dangerous. So just be careful with the slippery pavement, because I've seen many a tourist go whoops and fall on their butt on the slippery pavement. Now, it doesn't always rain here in Portugal, so it's not a big issue, but just pay attention because it can get very slick. And if there's dog poop there, it'll obviously be slick too. So that'll do it for you. Anyway, those are 10 things that I think that might shock you about visiting Portugal. What are some things that shocked you about visiting Portugal? Please put in the comments section below so we can have some more shocks. If you like videos like this, why don't you subscribe to our YouTube channel? Go down there and click the subscribe button. 10 things that'll shock you about Italy. 10 things that'll shock you about the US. 5 things you're loving about here in Lisbon. All on our website at WoltersWorld.com and here on our YouTube channel. Subscribe, get videos like this in your feed every week. Anyway, I'll say adeus or bye from the Belém district in Lisbon. I hope you're not too shocked about coming here to Portugal.